Hi guys, this is Abhishek Amrutham. In this video, we are gonna learn how to create surface or solid for the geometry created in previous video. We have created a geometry using three airfoil coordinates. I will consider this as a root and this as a tip, but the geometry orientation is not proper. I want this airfoil at plane sections, and this airfoil should be behind this root airfoil. Okay, now I am going to delete this thing. I am going to make some changes in this GSD sheet. This 500 thing is the root airfoil. I am giving it 0, and this thing I want at middle. Earlier I want it at the tip, so I give it 500. You can also give negative dimensions, it will create the opposite direction. Okay, this is good now, and I will start macros same as previous. Click 2 and the macros will run. Origin at 30% of the chord, root airfoil, but I have taken 0% of the chord at these airfoils. And for now we will just go through the surfacing part. Go to generative shape design in shape and generative shape design. This is same as wireframe and surface design, and it is the best and accurate way of defining the surfaces. Just click surfaces and take multi-section surfaces. This is same as multi-section solid in part design, but it will create a surface instead of a solid. And click this, or you can directly choose from the toolbars multi-section surface. We can observe that these airfoils are not closed, but we can close it in wireframe, or just we can close it using a surface. We will do that later. And directly click that cross section spline. Three splines, and make sure that this arrows face in same direction. And directly click preview. See, this is how the shape is formed. I have to move the coordinates. Okay, I don't want like this. I want more proper way. Okay, I can directly manually change that airfoil profile. That thing I will show you now. This is a 250 mm from this root chord, root airfoil, sorry. I will create a plane at 250. Okay, and this is at 500. I will create a plane at 500. Okay, these planes are created, and I will sketch a plane using sketcher using project 3D elements. I will project this geometry. Okay, before doing this thing, just click right click on a part body and click define in work object, so that every feature you create will be inside the part body, not in the self geometry from Excel. Now I have defined it in part body, and I will make a sketch on a plane which is 250 mm from the origin. Okay, and the same thing I will do with all the planes. Okay, I'm done with that thing, and I will directly hide this so that only the projected areas will be visible. And I am going to move this thing a slight towards left using translate. You can find translate in insert. Sorry, operations. The operations, you can choose translate or you can directly choose from the toolbar. Element is this thing, and a direction, Y component direction. Okay, I will move 25 mm. Okay, this is bit okay. Looks okay. And click show or hide initial element. This will make the previous one hide. Okay, I'm gonna do same thing with this thing also. Now I'm good with this. Okay, now try to connect these things. Arrows are in same direction. And preview. Yeah, this looks okay. This looks okay a bit. Okay, and you will find a gap here at the tip of the airfoil. You have to close that gap. If you want to make it as a solid thing, you have to make a closed surface. Now I'm gonna make a closed surface. Use this blend option, blend, and directly click top edge and the surface, and click bottom edge and the surface, and directly preview and okay. Now you can see that the surface will be formed here. Yeah, surface got formed from root to tip. Now you have to close these openings at the tip and the root. Just hide this wireframe. Okay, now use the fill option. These three are only important in this video. Use the fill option. Directly click this section, and you can see here that open end gap 0.34 mm. You have to close that by selecting that blend feature created, end of the blend feature. And if you see this closed counter, then you can close the surface, preview, okay. Now the surface is closed. Do same here, okay. And this surface is completely closed. Now you have to join these surfaces. Joining is very easy. Click join the operations toolbar and select from specification tree multi-section solid and blend feature, fill 1 and fill 2, and click OK. Everything will be in single surface. Now we can directly go to part design, and you can use the surface feature toolbar. This is thick surface, but we need a closed surface. Close surface and click on that surface, okay, and directly hide this join. Now you have created a wing using multiple airfoils. This is a wing. This can be a wing, or this can, if you modify the shape, it can be a compressor or turbine blade, or it can be a propeller as per your shape requirements. If you want it as a compressor blade, just a circular pattern of a compressor or turbine blades like this, or you can create a wing section you can also create a propeller section using a different shape and size features. Thank you for watching my video. If you have any doubts, please comment. And if you want a video on anything in CATIA, just mention it in the comments. Thank you. And please do subscribe to my channel.